On the night of March 16th, 1933, a Nazi stormtroop raided the laboratory of famous neuroscientists Oskar and Cecile Voigt, who were interrogated at gunpoint, accused of providing shelter to Jewish researchers. Who were these people who stood up against Nazi terror in the name of the international scientific community? Oskar Voigt was born in 1870 in a rural environment, fascinated by life and the workings of nature from a young age. With hard work and perseverance, he studied natural sciences with leading scholars all over Europe. In Paris, Oskar met Cecile, a talented researcher and one of the first female medical graduates in France. It was a meeting of minds and hearts. In the male-dominated field of science, Cecile was facing discrimination throughout her career. At a time when women were usually not tolerated at scientific conferences, Oskar refused to lecture unless his wife was admitted to join the event. Working as a hypnotherapist, he met steel magnate Friedrich Krupp, who agreed to fund Voigt's novel interdisciplinary laboratory. The world's first neuroscience institute opened in Berlin in 1899. With experts such as Corbinian Brodmann among its members, the team of the Neurologische Zentralstation soon achieved to define histologically distinct areas of the brain, developing methods for micrography and microtomy still used today. Renowned for his attempts in linking back the minds of geniuses to an extraordinary physiology of their brain, Oskar Voigt was approached by the Soviets to conduct the brain autopsy of the deceased Lenin. Voigt was in a dilemma. Pressured to confirm that Lenin was a political genius while facing growing anti-communist sentiments in Germany. Pointing out the unusual number and size of pyramidal cells in Lenin's cortex, Voigt cleverly settled for a middle ground that left room for interpretation. When the Nazis seized power, the Voigts were increasingly facing defamation and harassment due to their internationally minded spirit of research. As leaders of the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute for Brain Research, they saw their premises being raided and lab equipment destroyed on several occasions. In 1935, Oskar was banned as a neuroscientist altogether, and the family had to move to the south of Germany, where they continued to work in a private institute, joined by their two daughters, by now leading scientists themselves. With their astonishing dedication and persistence, the names of Oskar and Cecile Voigt are forever linked to the foundations of interdisciplinary neuroscience. They are model scientists who believed that the power of bringing people together for a common aim is a central quality of the scientific endeavor, which will always overcome any crudeness and animosity in its path.